Take a look at Chris. He is next. Has he done his homework?
I have done a little research coming in. My dad actually used to sing Henry VIII, I Am, to me when I was a kid. But you won in 2001, won Sexiest Artist Alive.
And I know, isn't that embarrassing? You wonder how I did it. I paid everybody off. You just have to make people think that you're sexy. And you can do that with songs. How could you choose a more sensual song than I'm Henry VIII, I Am?
Right.
Every teenage girl chases you once you go with that.
Right. I am a huge, huge, huge British Invasion fan. I chose She's Not There by the Zombies.
Perfect.
Well, no one told me about her. I really want to sing the song well. I mean, it's one of my favorite songs.
What's the song about?
Peter Noon gave the best advice that I could get for that song.
If you can figure out what it's about and make it your song, the audience will buy it 100%. They'll go, wow. If you've got a lyric that you've got to deliver, it has to make people in the audience believe you and feel the feeling. This is a good story. You'll do great with this song. You'll do great.
I really appreciate
Thank
it.
You.
Thank you.
But last week he got in trouble with the arrangement from the judges. And so I hope he's not going to tread too carefully with the song.
Another track from the Zombies, going all the way back to 1964 with She's Not There. It is Chris Sligh.
No one told me about her, where she lied. Well, no one told me about her, how many people cried. And it's too late to say you're sorry. Why should I worry? Why should I care? Please don't bother trying to find her. She's not there. Though they all knew, but it's too late to say you're sorry. Why should I worry? Why should I care? Please don't bother trying to find her. She's not there. Well, let me tell you about the way she looks, the way she acts, and the color of her hair. Her voice is soft and cool, her eyes are clear and bright, but she's not
man. Everybody's performing tonight, man. I liked it. You coming out of the crowd and stuff, dude. It's like a concert in here, dog. It started off a little bit rough because you were a little ahead of the beat because you were probably walking and shaking hands and talking and stuff like that. But you wound up good, man. I mean, it's a great song for you, actually. I thought you ended it really strong. It started a little rough for me, though. A little ahead of the beat, you
a
know
little,
what I mean?
A little ahead of the pocket. But,
yeah.
But other than that, I think, first of all, I think you're dressing much nicer.
Yeah, I like the shirts.
I like the fact that you're working the audience, but really feel free to like be more personable with the audience. Mm-hmm. Other than that, I thought your vocals were really good.
Oh, you jump down, shake Simon's hand, whatever.
Oh, and doing that to Simon, yeah. Yeah, whatever.
What else could he have done to be more free with the audience?
I know.
He could have taken the mic stand and really jabbed you.
No, but seriously, what could he have done more to be personable to the audience?
No, I see what she's saying, Simon. I mean,
which is what?
I could have, you know, turned to the audience a little bit more, but the song is something that's a little bit dark. I mean, it's talking about a girl that's not there, you know.
I actually don't think you had a problem with the audience, actually. Chris, I think you did your thing.
Oh, gosh,
you know? I'm serious.
Thank you.
I saw, you know, I mean it. I thought it was fun. You know, it wasn't the best vocal we've heard tonight, but it was a good choice of song for you.
Yeah, you showed
personality. And I thought you did a lot better than last week, actually, Chris.
Thank you so much.
Chris Sligh.
Is it trickier roaming through all the people navigating your way back and forth?
It is, because you got to focus on the camera. You got to focus on not tripping, because I'm a little clumsy and